Hello. Well, I wonder if you've seen this month's copy of TV Life. In it, for the first time, is a new regular cookery feature with our own Good Afternoon cook, Mary Berry. So each month from now on, what Mary shows you on our Wednesday programme will be in the magazine. And today we're looking at vegetables and cheese. Now, why have you chosen these and why the combination?
Well, that meat is getting so expensive, Judith. I'm turning, in our family, to using more cheese. And we've got a lot of vegetables in the garden, and vegetables soon will be becoming cheaper. And a combination of the two goes well.
Very nutritious too, of course.
Yes, indeed. Yes.
These are some of the vegetables we can get in the shops now.
Yes, I'm going to do a dish with peppers, which are in the shops now, and they will be getting cheaper, and I'm making one pepper do two people.
They are pretty expensive, those, but then you have alternatives in mind.
Yes, you could always use a marrow, something like that.
Mm. And the little beans, of course, they're quite new at the moment.
Well, soon we'll have runner beans, and then, of course, there's usually a glut, so we want lots of recipes to use those.
Mm. Some marvellous selection of cheeses here.
These cheeses here are really the ones that we usually have at the table, and these hard cheeses are suitable for cooking. My favourite, of course, is cheddar cheese, because that's the one you can get everywhere. Lancashire is good too, and some of the continental cheeses, Dutch Gouda, Emmental, a bit expensive but very good. And then I find that a lot of recipes call for grated cheese, and this grater is very reasonable. It's about 25 pence in one of the chain stores, and I think it's a good idea because you can grate the cheese on two types of grades, and then the cheese goes down into the bowl. It won't do hard, really hard cheeses.
I was
going
to say, the only trouble I've ever had with things like that is that with a hard cheese it's not strong enough, really.
No, it's not strong enough and it slips. I'm talking of slipping. This one, I find that I get more on my feet and down my trousers than I do in the bowl. So I don't really recommend that one. I think it slips away from you. I'd much prefer something rigid that you can lean on, like this one, and then it collects all the cheese underneath.
Mm.
Sometimes you get little tiny bits left. You know, if it was particular, something like Lancashire, or bits left on the cheese board, and this grates soft cheeses very well, and you just press the top down. I think this is about 50 pence, and you see it comes out beautifully finely.
Oh, and that sorts out all your, as you say, those little bits that get left and are
and then
very
there's
difficult
no
to
waste.
Hold.
Mm, mm. You can keep grated cheese in the refrigerator too, to use in dishes. So really, with cheese, there should be no waste at all.
I'm going to pick up my marrow and join
you over here
now, because we're going on to some of the recipes that are in the magazine, and you're starting with stuffed peppers, aren't you?
Yes. Now, stuffed peppers, when I've tried other recipes, sometimes, Judith, they've been rather dry, and you get a whole pepper, usually, and it's quite expensive. So for this recipe, I'm just going to cut the top off there, and then cut it in half, and make half do each person. And then you really need to pull out the seeds in the middle. And then you, to make it soft, before stuffing, you blanch it. And that is just plunging in boiling water for about 5 minutes, and that just softens the flesh. It changes the colour a bit too.
As you say, they are fairly expensive at the moment still, and so an alternative is marrow, did you say?
Yes, you can use a marrow like this one. This is a nice young one, rings of marrow. Of course you can use aubergines, they're expensive, so I would either use half a pepper or marrow for this recipe, and blanch a little less time for marrow.
Why, because it's a softer skin?
That's right, yes.
Terribly intelligent all.
And for the filling for the peppers, I'm going to use some minced beef, and not the usual pound, because with the cheese sauce and the extra protein from the cheese, you don't need it so much meat. And for the recipe, I'm using 8 ounces of minced beef and one large onion chopped up. And you cook those two together. And don't add extra fat, because if you do, you'll get a very fatty result. There should be some fat in the meat, which comes out, and you cook the onion with it for half an hour. And then you add a little flour, and the flour wants to be plain, a heaped tablespoonful. And then some grated carrot, and grated on the cheese, grater, you don't need to wash it in between whiles. And then a little bit of stock, about 1/4 pint. Now, we won't have stock about, so I've put a stock cube in there. And so you could cook all together for about half an hour until the mince is tender. And I've got some already cooked here.
And you don't need salt or pepper in that?
Yes, go easy on the salt, because a stock cube is rather salty.
Mm.
So I'm just going to put a tiny little bit, because we've got one stock cube for 1/4 pint. And then fill each pepper with the mixture. And remember that this could be marrow if you prefer. And it's lovely and wet and moist. I'm not very keen on these fillings that have a lot of rice in and things like that, because I'm always rather disappointed in them.
Mm. What a mixture of so many good things there, haven't
yes,
you?
Yes, lovely. And the carrot helps to give it colour too. Mm. And then I'm going to put a white sauce round the outside. And to make a good white sauce, cheesy, you need a well-flavoured cheese, and that's what I've got.
I find sauces an awful fag to make, I must say, and I get them rather easily lumpy. And then they dry if you're not careful on the top and leave them any length of time, don't they, form a skin?
Yes, they do. I make mine with a whisk, and that's maybe different from other people do it with a wooden spoon. I can't get the movement and the beating with a spoon so well as I can with a whisk. Now, when I say a whisk, it's this whisk, and it's a very cheap one, and it's a little one for a small pan. In the pan, I've got 1 ounce of butter or margarine, and I'm going to add to that 1 ounce of flour. Now, I'd never weigh 1 ounce of flour. How about that? 1 ounce is a rounded tablespoon. And I shall add 1/2 pint of milk. Now, stir. Just lifting that off the heat so that it doesn't catch. And then I'm going to add the milk. Now, this is a basic white sauce. It needn't necessarily be milk. It could be stock, or half stock and half milk. Now, I'm beating all the time. Now, this little whisk bends and gets right into the corner. And I'm just going to let that all included so we don't get a lumpy sauce. And a little bit more milk. I usually add about 1/2 the milk. That's down to 1/4 pint. I can read it. You can just. And then I'm going to put it back on the heat. Now, you'll notice that I turn the heat on because I want to make it fairly quickly.
You obviously don't use a non-stick pan if you're making a sauce with a whisk.
No, because you would find that you would ruin the pan. Mm. But this is the quickest way, and if you do end up with a lumpy sauce, just give it a jolly good whisk, or if you've got it lucky enough to have a blender, put it in the blender and it'll be smooth. I think sieving is about the worst operation. Mm. It's rather mucky.
Coming very quickly through, isn't it?
Yes, and then the last of the milk. That's 1/2 pint. So I'll just repeat, 1 ounce of butter on the generous side rather than the skimpy side, and then 1 ounce of flour and 1/2 pint of milk. So that's the basic white sauce, and it's what at school we called a coating sauce, and that means that it'll cover things. Now this needs seasoning. It's had nothing added at the moment. You can see it really boiling and it's shiny.
Not a lump inside.
That's more luck than management. Now salt and pepper. I suppose in theory you should use white pepper, but I always use black, as you know. Mm. And then a little mustard, made mustard or prepared mustard. And then cheese. And I'm adding well-flavoured cheddar cheese to this recipe.
So that's mature cheddar.
That's right, yes.
That's what they call it on the packets, isn't it, if you buy it?
That's right. There we are. And then pour it round the peppers. Now, this is rather a crammed dish, so I'm just going to lift one off and then pour it round. A little bit more at the other end. Now, this really does mean that you get a moist recipe. If you sit these peppers without a sauce all the way around the outside, you'll find, there we are, that it won't be very delicious. It'll be rather dry, so it's well worth doing a good sauce.
What about leaving it, sort of doing it in the morning if you're having people for supper at night? Would it stay quite happily like that?
Yes, I would leave it like that in the refrigerator and then bake it afterwards. And I should use a slightly bigger dish than I've done, and it's very difficult to have so many dishes. I've got one in the oven and I did it in a slightly bigger one here.
How long do you cook it for?
About 1/2 hour. At 350. There we are. Now that's a more sensible sized dish, and as you can see, come over the top.
Mm. Well, they look jolly good, I must say.
Yes, well, I think they're delicious and they're full of flavour.